Dear learners, I am Dr. Sunil Lohate. Today, we will discuss on the important diseases of guava, their causal organisms, disease symptoms, disease cycle and control measures. Guava crop is an important fruit crop of the subtropical region. The guava crop is affected by various fungi, bacteria, algae and nematode. Wilt, fruit canker, anthracnose and styler end rot are the major diseases of guava. Let us get the information about guava fruit canker. The guava fruit canker is major fungal disease. The symptoms of this disease occurs generally on green fruits and rarely on leaves. Initially very small, brown or rust colored circular necrotic, that is dead areas, appears on the fruits. Further, in advanced stage of infection, outer layer of fruit ruptures, affected portions get raised and central portion of it is depressed. In severe cases, raised cancerous spots develop in great numbers and fruits get cracked. Seeds are exposed. Infected fruits remain underdeveloped, become hard, malform and drop prematurely. The pathogen remains survived in infected fruits. Wind is responsible for spread of the disease. The spores of this disease enters through wounds. The germination of the spores is maximum at 30 degrees Celsius and it do not germinate below 50 degrees Celsius. Disease increases with increase in the humidity. Collection and destruction of infected fruits from orchards is one of the important steps in the management of this disease. After incidence of disease, spray the fungicide 1% Bordeaux mixture 3 to 4 times at an interval of 10 to 15 days. Another important disease of guava is wilt. Wilt is a devastating fungal disease of guava crop. The first symptom of this disease starts with the onset of rainy season. The plant may develop light yellow leaves with loss of turgidity. The plants defoliate entirely and fruit shed prematurely. Some of the twigs fail to bring new leaves and flowers and finally dry up. Fruits of all the affected branches remain underdeveloped, hard and stony. The plants defoliate entirely and dries up. The roots also show rotting at the basal region. The bark of affected plant is easily detachable from the cortex. Light brown discoloration is also noticed in vascular tissues of the bark. The older trees are more prone to this disease. This is a soil-borne disease and it spreads through the infected soil, injurious roots and running water. High rainfall during August-September is favorable for the development of this disease. Stagnation of water in guava field for long duration is also responsible. Temperature range between 23 to 32 degrees Celsius with 76% relative humidity are conducive for the development of this disease. Proper field sanitation in the orchard is very important for prevention of this disease. For this purpose, wilted trees should be uprooted and burned. Dug out trench around the tree trunk to avoid the contact of infected plants with healthy plants. While transplanting, care should be taken to avoid injury to the roots. Proper application of organic manures, oil cakes, lime and balanced fertilizer also check the disease. Use of rootstock resistant to wilt will prevent the disease occurrence. Biological agents like trichoderma species, aspergillus niger is also found very effective. These bioagents are mixed with farmyard manure and it is applied at the rate of 5 kg per peat at the time of planting. For older plants, the mixtures are applied at the rate of 10 kg per peat. Partially wilted plants recovered fully after the rejuvenation or heavy pruning of the tree. Another important disease is anthracnose. It is also known as fruit rot or dieback of guava. This is also a fungal disease. It mainly occurs on leaves, branches and on fruits. The plant begins to die backwards from the top of the branch. Young shoots, leaves and fruits are readily attacked. The greenish color of the growing tip is changed to dark brown and later to black necrotic areas. Further development of disease starts from the infected twigs and then spread on petiole and on young leaves. These young infected leaves drop down and twigs are dried. Fruit and leaf infection is generally seen during rainy season crop. Pinhead spots are first seen on unripe fruits which gradually enlarge. Spots are dark brown in color, sunken and circular. Several spots joins together to form bigger lesions. The infected area on unripe fruits become corky and hardy. Severe infection causes cracking of the fruits. The disease infection spread by windborne spores developed on dead leaves, twigs and mummified fruits in the orchard. Transportation of infected planting material and infected fruits are another reasons for the spread of this disease. The dense canopy is congenial for germination of spores due to high moisture condition. Temperature between 24 to 28 degrees Celsius is congenial for the development of this disease. Spraying of 1% borax mixture or 0.3% copper oxychloride just after initiation of the disease will help to manage this disease. Clean cultivation and strict sanitation in the orchard also helps to reduce this disease. Recommended plant density, proper water management, nutrient management will prevent the spread of this disease. Styler end rot is another fungal disease which occurs severely during the rainy season. The visible disease symptoms appears as discoloration in the region lying just below and adjoining the persistent calyx. Such area gradually increases in size and turn dark brown. Later, the affected area becomes soft. The outer skin of fruit and pulp inside become discolored. The diseased fruits become pulpy and brown in color as compared to healthy fruit. Pathogen survives in infected fruits and plant debris and spread through wind. Temperature 10 to 35 degrees Celsius is favorable for disease development. Collection and destruction of infected fruits from the orchard is the effective management practice. 3 to 4 sprays of mancozeb 75% wettable powder at the rate of 0.2% at 10 days interval during monsoon season will manage this disease very effectively. Clean cultivation, judicious use of nutrients, use of quality and disease free planting material, use of bioagents and biofertilizers are important management aspects to keep the orchards healthy and disease free. Thank you.